church service. We want to welcome everybody and greet you in the name of the Lord. I hope you come to mind the Lord tonight. Amen. We're in Father's house. Amen. Let's come together. Let's have church by your side.
Amen.
Amen. Brother Rogers, we're ready for service. Right now, we'd like the choir to come up. Let's sing a couple songs. And we'll get started. But now, mind the Lord, church. If God gives you something, you do it, all right? We believe in shouting here, though.
Amen.
Amen. All right.
Long years ago, I'm
Give A. Yes, sir.
Hey, Brother Jeremy, you want to leave? You want to leave, sir?
Thank you. Y'all pray for me.
That's the Lord.
Lord, help me walk another mile, just one more mile. I'm tired, Lord, of walking all alone. And Lord, please help me smile, another smile, just one more smile. Cause now I know that I can't make it on my own.
long black train coming down the line.
Bless the Lord.
Beating all the souls that are lost and crying. Rivers of sin, only evil remains. Watch out, brother, for that long black train. You can look to the heavens, you can look to the sky. You can find redemption staring back to your eyes. There is protection and there's peace of sight. Burning your ticket for that long black train. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train.
Listen, boy.
There's an engineer on that long black train, making you wonder if the ride is worth the pain. He's just waiting on your heart to say, let me ride on that long black train. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. I can hear the whistle from a mile away. It sounds so good, but I must stay away. That train is a beauty, making everybody stare. But its only destination is the middle of nowhere. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. Well, I say cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. Yeah, watch out, brother, for that long black train. That devil's a-driving that long black train.
When I When everything falls apart,
This way tonight, but you know, most of all, I want to thank you for saving my soul from a devil's hell. You know, most of all, a lot of times we get down in this life, this world is getting wickeder and wickeder every day that we turn around. You see things are going on, and all it's leading up to is the end of time when the Lord comes back to take His church and His bride up out of here, people that is prepared and ready to go home to be with Him, that's got their sins covered by the precious blood of the Lamb, the only blood that will ever wash you white as snow, the only blood that will ever heal you, the only blood that will ever take you all the way to heaven. It's the only thing that can wash you and cleanse you and make you as white as snow and make you fit for the kingdom of God. If you have got the blood applied to your heart and to your life, you're not going to the place that I'm going to. But I've got my mind made up, my feet upon a rock, and I've got my name on a roll. You can say, well, he's a rock and roller. Yes, I am. I've got my feet upon that rock, and my mind's made up that I'm going home one day for a while to a place that Jesus Christ said I'm going away to prepare a place for you. If I go away to prepare a place for you, I'll come again to receive you unto myself that where I am, there you may be also. I tell you what, it ain't going to be a glorious time. One day after a while, and when we get to hear the Lord say, well done, thou good and faithful servant, enter now into the joy of thy Lord. I tell you what a glorious time that's going to be when we get to cross over and see our loved one that's gone on before us and see the one that's paved the way for us to be able to go to this place that Jesus has prepared for you and I tonight. But I'm here to tell you tonight, there's another place that has been prepared, and it wasn't prepared for us tonight. It was prepared for the devil and his angel, which is called hell. And if you go to hell, you go over the shed blood of Jesus Christ tonight. And I tell you what, it's not God's will and that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Every knee is going to bow, every tongue is going to confess that Jesus is the Lord unto the glory of God. For the day is the day of salvation. Now is the accepted time, church. I'm telling you why. It's going to be a glorious time when we get to make heaven our home and we get to talk home about this old sin-stricken world, a world of trouble, a world of trial, a world of temptation. And I tell you why, I'm going to a place where I'll never get old. I'm going to a place where I'll never die. I'm going to a place where I'll never have cancer. I'm going to a place where I'll never be sick. I won't be blind anymore. I'll have a brand new set of eyes to look through. And I tell you what, I'm going to have a glorified body of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I tell you what, a body that'll never get old. It'll never hurt. It'll never see death. But you know what? There's coming a time God is going to judge this sin-stricken world. And He's going to pour out His wrath upon this world. And if you've been left behind, you're going to face the mighty wrath of Almighty God. I tell you what, Jesus sent out His disciples one day, and He went up on a mountain to pray. And as He was up our prayer, His disciples went and got into a ship, and they went out into the sea. And about the fourth watch of the night, Jesus was going to crawl on that sea and pass by them. But you know what? They looked out, and they saw Him come out, and they got afraid, because they thought they had saw the Spirit. And Jesus said, be not afraid, it is I. And you know what? Peter stepped out and he said, Lord, if it be you, bid me come unto you. And He said, come. And Peter stepped out of that boat and he started walking upon the water. But you know what? The wind started blowing, the waves started rushing. That's the way life is today. All of a sudden, we're on a smooth road. Everything everything's going good, everything's going the way we want it to go, and then all of a sudden, our troubles and trials, our touch it takes us, and they'll drag us down. But you know what? Peter, he didn't keep his eye upon the Lord. He took them all, and he began to sing, and you know what he done? He cried out, "The Lord, save me!" And Jesus reached down his arm, lifted him up, and said, "Wherefore, I did thy doubt." You know what? If you're here, and you're lost, and undone, and without God, all you gotta do is say, "Lord, save me," and he will save you tonight from the devil's hell. But I tell you what, in this life, you're going to have troubles and trials and tribulation. It's not going to be always smooth. And if anyone ever tells you that a Christian way is easy, I'm here to tell you tonight, it's not easy, but it's the best life I've ever chose to do. And I tell you what, I wouldn't turn back into that old world for nothing. Jesus said, "Away from man gain, if he was to gain the whole world and lose his own soul, or what would a man give in exchange for his soul?" And you know what? There's a law in hell right now that will give anything and everything that they ever had just to have the opportunity that you've got tonight. They would a great place with you in an instant. And I guarantee you, they wouldn't wait under the altar. They'd already be up here at this altar asking God for forgiveness. He's faithful, just and true, to forgive you of your sin. And you know what? Sin only lasts for a season, and then it's gone. After your love, it brings forth sin, and after sin has conceived, it brings forth death. Or tonight, if death was to take you out of this world, how would you face God? Would you be able to lift up your hand and say, "Come, Lord Jesus"? Or would you have to say, "I'm not ready to go right now"? But you know what? Death has no respect of a person. You can go to any cemetery as you want to go to, and you can find them from a day old to 100 years old. Death has no respect of a person. You can say, "I'm a young, I've got a long life to live." But I tell you what, the book of James tells me our life is but a vapor. It appears for a little while, and then it vanishes away. We none have a promise of a tomorrow. We none have a promise of getting home tonight. But you know what? I have got a promise of making heaven my home. And I like God, and I love the blood of my heart and in my life. I have accepted Jesus Christ into my heart and into my life. Jesus Christ, I so love the world, that God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever shall believe upon him, I should not perish, but I have everlasting life. And you know what? A lot of times I've got to look up and I've got to say, "Lord, it's me again. I messed up one more time." But you know what? He's faithful and true, and he'll forgive us of our sin. You know what he'll do? He'll cast your sin as far as the east is from the west, and never be brought before you again. There was another young man in the Bible who was wealthy, had everything that he ever wanted. He didn't want for nothing. But you know what? He looked out across the world and he thought, and you know what? I can imagine, I wonder what is out there. And you know the devil, I will tell you, I can go to here or go yonder and see how it's like. But you know what? He's going to paint you a pretty picture, but he'll never turn that picture around and let you see what's on the other side of that picture. This young man, he went to his father and he said, "Father, I've bestowed unto me a portion of my good." His father divided the goods with him. And a few days later, this young man took a journey into a far country, and he spent all his living upon righteous living, a harlot, a drinking, adultery, a fornication, just whatever the world out there has got to offer you. But I'm here to tell you what this world has to offer you will not give you nothing but the pits of hell. It will take you straight to hell. One day, after a while, there's nothing out there
chapter worth dying and going to hell over. So then it was a great famine come through the man. Everybody was hungry. This young man, he had spent everything he had. Have you ever felt as like you was down to the last time you ever had or you had done and hit rock bottom? That's the only thing that you can do now is just look up and look toward God and say, Lord, save me. You know what? If you're in that position tonight, the Lord is right here tonight to save you. If you'll just ask him to, this young man, he got a job with a citizen of that country, and he got a job feeding the swine, and he got so hungry that he said, I will eat the husk that the swine do eat. But you know what happened to him? He come to himself, and he said, you know what? How many hired servants back at my father's house have plenty enough to eat, and I perish with hunger. He realized that it was better back at father's house. He said, I'll go back and I'll say unto my father, I'm no worthy because thy son have made me as one of thy hired servants. And you know what? The world will drag you down. The world will take you further than you want to go. But I tell you what, I'm no one that will stick her closer than a brother. His name is Jesus. He said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'll go with you all the way, even to the end of the world. And that's a promise that we can stand on tonight. This young man, he took off and he started back to his father's house. But you know what? The father was standing for her looking down the road. And when he saw his son coming down the road, he run and hugged him and kissed him. And he said, kill the fatted calf, for this my son was lost, he's now found. This my son that was dead is alive again. I bring a new robe and put upon him. When you take that old robe off, Jesus will put a new robe upon you. A robe without spot, without blemish, without wrinkle. He'll put a robe upon you. A fit for the kingdom of God. He said, put a ring on his finger and shoes on his feet. I tell you what, you may go out into this old world, but it's always better at the Father's house. I tell you why, all we got to do is come back and say, Lord, save me, and he will save you from the devil's hell. But you've got to realize that you're lost and you're undone and you were without God. And if you was to die, hell would be your home right tonight. But you have got an opportunity to accept the words that Jesus Christ did upon Calvary, the dead, the world, and the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and the blood that he shed on that mountain to cover all of our sin. You see, Jesus was the only one I found worthy enough to come down here and hang and die upon that old rugged cross, that we could have life and have it more abundantly. And while he was hanging there, you know what he said? He said, Father, I forgive them, for they know not what they do. And I tell you what, he'll forgive you just like he forgave those. But you know what? He could have called 12 legions of angels at any time to come down here and to destroy this earth. But he had so much love.
Amen.
He had so much love in his heart for you and I tonight. He looked down to the future and he saw that we all needed a Savior. He saw that we all needed something in our heart and in our life. And it was him. His precious love was what held him up on that cross. It wasn't the nail that he drove in his hand or in his feet. It was the love that he had for a lost in a dying world. Jesus Christ came down here seeking to save that which was lost. And I tell you what, he's here tonight to save you if you'll just accept him into your heart and into your life. And you don't have to tell him everything that you've done, because he already knows everything that you've done. All you got to do is accept him in your heart and believe that he did what he said he did, that he's the Son of God, and that he was buried and rose the third day, and confess him with your mouth, and thou shalt be saved. And whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Lord, I shall be saved. He didn't exclude a nobody. Are you down at your lowest point in your life? Are you tired of the way you're living? Are you tired of the way things is going? Because you don't have nobody that you can go to. I've got somebody that I can go to, and his name is Jesus Christ. I'm standing at the right hand of the Father. I'm making intercession for me tonight, and all we got to do is go to him, and he'll take care of every problem that we've ever got. He'll take care of what we need. He'll fill you up like you've never been filled up before. Like y'all can't do it. Pills can't do it. Drugs can't do it. A shot can't do it. A woman can't do it. A man can't do it. A computer can't do it. But I can tell you the man that I can do it. It's Jesus Christ tonight. And he'll make you higher than you've ever been in your life before. And I tell you why. And Peter the book said, it's not God's will that any should perish, but that all I should come to repentance. Every knee is going to bow. Every tongue is going to confess that Jesus is the Lord of the glory of God. For the day is the day of salvation, and now is the accepted time. If this young man hadn't come back out of the Father's house, he still would be lost and unknown and without God. But I tell you what, he had enough sin to realize of where he was at. How do you stand out of now with God? There was another man, a rich man. He fired sumptuously every day. In other words, he got more and more and more every day of his life. And there was another man by the name of Lazarus. I laid at the rich man's gate, and all he begged for was the crumb that fell from the rich man's table. But you know what? This rich man, he never had no compassion upon the beggar man. He went on about his life. I'm going here, I'm going there, I'm buying this, I'm selling that, I'm getting more and more every day. You know what? You may give a lot of things in this world, but when you die, you're not going to take none of it with you. And I tell you what, it's going to be laid up for someone else, out of you. But I tell you what, it came to pass that this beggar man was so sick that the dog came and licked his sore. That beggar rich man never had enough compassion to help with a beggar man. You know what? In our Christian walk, we got to help one another. I didn't live this life to help one another. I didn't make heaven our home one day. After a while, I don't want to see one die and go to the devil's hell. And you know what? It come to pass that this rich man died, and from the pit of the hell, he lifted up his eyes and he looked afar off. But the older, better man, he died too. And the angels came down and carried him in the Father Abraham's bosom. And the rich man looked up, and what did he see? He saw a beggar man comforted in Abraham's bosom. Yeah. But you know what? This rich man, at this time, he was a begging, he was a pleading, he was asking for help. And you know what? He said, Father Abraham, Father Abraham, have mercy upon me, for I am in torment in this awful flame. I seen Lazarus down here, dip his finger in water, cool my tongue. For he is in torment in this flame. And Abraham said, nay, he cannot come unto you, and you cannot come unto us. And all you see, when you go to hell, you're not going to be able to get out of this awful place. Or you're not going to be able to escape those weeping and wailing and gnashing the teeth over the fire. His member queen and the worm dies not. But you know what? Abraham said, there is a great God between you and us, and you can't go to us, and we can't go to you. He said, Father Abraham, now listen to this now. He said, Father Abraham, I seen Lazarus back to my father's house where I have five brethren, and I don't want them to come out of this awful place of a torment. And Abraham said that they had Moses and the prophet. I let them hear them. And he said, nay, even one rose from the dead, they would hear. And Father Abraham said, nay, if they won't hear Moses and the prophet, and neither will they hear one rose from the dead. And so you know what? When you're going to have plague called hell. You're going to have all of your senses. You're going to have all of your memory. You're going to have everything that you had upon this earth. You're going to smell. You're going to taste. You're going to feel. And you're going to burn for eternity. And no way to get out of it. And no escaping. It'll be too late for you to ask the Lord to bring you then. But right now is the time of the day. Is the day of salvation. You can either go to hell or you can go to heaven. There's a heaven to gain and a hell to shun. You know what? I want to shun an awful place called hell. I want to make a hell of my home. I tell you what, there's nothing down there in hell worth going there for. And I tell you what, you're not going to find a real love down there. You're not going to find a pills or a shot down there. You're not going to find nothing down there but torment and agony forever and forever and forever. But you know what? I'm going to a place where the street are pure as gold. I'm going to a place where Jesus said, I go away to prepare a place for you. And if I go away and prepare a place for you, I'll come again and receive you by myself. That where I am, there you may be also. I'm going to a place where the crystal river is. I'm going to a place where I can bow down before my Savior and say, thank you, Lord, for all that you have done for me. I want to forgive him. I praise for him. Honor of why I'm alive. I've been here upon this earth because when death takes me out of here, I'm going home. I'll be with the one that I'm going to die upon an old rugged cross that I can have life and have it more abundantly. And I tell you what, the day you're going to choose life or you're going to choose death. And I tell you what, I'll advise you to choose life tonight. I don't choose death. I don't choose that world. And I tell you what, the devil is going to live and fro, seeking and devour whoever he may. He's going to try you down. He's going to try to keep you down. But I tell you, the one that will lift you up every time you fall, he'll dust you off. He'll raise you up. It's Jesus Christ. And when you think that as you're going through the lowest valley of your life all by yourself, I guess what? Jesus Christ is the living in that valley, and he's right there with you all the way. He said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'll go with you even to the end of the world. But what more can we ask for?
Right.
What more could we ask for?
Never find another friend like
Jesus. Jesus said, I'll stick closer than a brother. He'll stick closer to you than your own family will. He'll stick closer to you than your wife will. He'll stick closer to you than your girlfriend will. He'll stick closer to you than anybody will. You'll not find no one like Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, the one who came down here was seeking to save that which was lost.
Amen.
And I tell you what, church, and it's going to be a glorious time. And when that trumpet sounds, and the dead in Christ rises first, and we that are alive and remain, I shall be called up to meet the Lord in the air. And there shall we ever be with the Lord. If the Lord was to come back right now, how could you stand up and say, here I am? Or would you have to run up to this altar and say, Lord, forgive me? If you're going to run up here to this altar, it's going to be too late, because it's going to happen in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. And I tell you what, you can't say, Lord, forgive me.
We won't have time.
How do you stand with God tonight? How do you stand with God tonight? Are you in His grace? Or are you in His disgrace? It's up to you. You can be in His grace tonight.
Amen.
You can be in His fellowship tonight. You can be cradled in His arms tonight.
Yep.
You can feel what we feel here tonight.
Amen.
But it's your choice. Someone come on, get a song. Come on, Brother Bobby. I feel I've preached what God has given me to preach tonight.
Amen.
When the Lord tells me to stop, that's when I stop.
Amen.
I feel He's told me to stop.
I don't believe you can preach it any plainer than what Brother Allen just preached. He told you the truth. Would you stand with me, church? Let's give an invitation. Somebody might want to pray tonight. I don't know everyone's heart in here, but I know a man that does. Jesus knows your heart. He knows how you stand tonight, ready or not ready. And guess what? You're in a good place to get ready. This whole world is a get ready place. My friends, if you're here and you're lost, I hope that the message he preached to you will enter into your heart and you'll heed to what the Spirit is saying to you. As Brother Kevin sings, this altar is open. Anyone that wants to pray,
will you come?
Will you just step out of your seat and come on down?
Yeah, and you wait.
You feel that your heart's pounding right now. You're sweating. You're
sweating.
Your hands are shaking. The knees are shaking. That's God.
Church, I want you to pray. Come on.
Pray for
me. I'll
say it to you.
Come on, the Lord. You work for me. I'll give you grace. Take my cloak.
Sometimes I question
what the devil's going to take
you out of the
next one. Wait till another time.
We just step out of your seat right now. Come on.
How do you know you have
any time?
How do you know you have another opportunity?
We have to lose my fear.
Just a simple saying, Lord, forgive us. Come on.
Gets so
how do you know? You put your shoes on this morning.
Is there wrong? Come on, baby.
Would you come in?
Yeah.
We say Jesus Christ is Lord.
Don't
turn away,
Lord.
When
I wish you all the victory,
it's like when you
come to the rises of
all these people said,
crucified.
No one
has this me.
Say what you want to say tonight. Say your words to me tonight. I don't want nothing to do.
He never promised.
If you believe Alan preached you the truth and you want this church to keep praying for you, Would you slip out of your seat and come and take him by the hand and say, keep praying for me, preacher?
I promise you.
Would you do that, buddy? And if you can't move out of your seat, you want to be saved, raise your hand up and we'll come and pray with you right here. We'll come right back to your seat. Kneel down. How many of you do that much? Just come down and take him by the hand.
Come on.
Take him by the hand and say, preacher, keep praying for me. How many of you do just that much? Say, keep praying for me. I'm telling you, if you knew how close the end is, you'd walk down this aisle. The end is drawing down. It's a world about to wrap it up, baby.
Would you come?
And Jesus is coming. I'm glad I'm ready. I'm glad I know that if Jesus comes today, I'm ready to go. If death comes my way, I'm ready to go. I don't want to die, but I'm not afraid to die. Why? Because I've got the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ in my heart. You can have it too.
Come on.
Will you just come down and take it by the hand and say, pray for me, please? You can go right back to your seat. Nobody will trick you. Nobody will try to hold you. You can go right back to your seat if you want to. Just let the man go and preach you the truth.
My sins are gone.
Your sins can be gone tonight. Will you do that?
My God, my Savior, has ransomed me.
Just come and shake his hand.
If you'll just lift up your hand, lift up the bottle of your eyes.
Amazing grace.
If you'd like for this church to keep praying for you, would you at least lift up your hand and say, keep praying for me?
Yeah.
Keep praying for me. It won't save you. But I do want to keep the church praying.
Let me step in the right direction.
Slip up your hands and the church is through. It's all there is to do that much.
Will someone do that?
Lift up the hand.
My home secures. His hand rests on my shield.
Raise your hand and put it back there.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
As long as life
is just a great thing,
my chains are
this. If I knew it felt this good, I'd have done it a long time ago. I felt that way. Jeremy felt that way. Everybody in here felt that way. It feels good to know you're saved. You can lay your head on your pillow at night and not worry about it if you don't wake up, because you know you're going to a better place. Every saint of God that's ever left here ahead of us, they knew they had a better place to go. And guess what? That is not the end of things. We're going to see them again. Because Thessalonians, the 4th chapter, 1 Thessalonians, it says, those that sleep, the Lord will bring with him when he comes. He's going to bring them back, and their bodies are going to come up out of the grave. Praise God. And that soul and spirit's going to be reunited. It's going to be glorified and be like Jesus. And we're going to rise up to meet him in the air. I'm glad for that promise tonight. What a wonderful service. It's been a good service. Brother Allen preached the truth. He preached the word of God to you. Two places, heaven or hell. That was the theme of the message tonight. And there's no in between. There's no purgatory or resting place. It's either one or the other. Jesus proved that with the rich man and Lazarus. He told about the rich man that he nearly lifted up his eyes. He told about Lazarus that Abraham received him into a place called paradise, waiting on that glorious day when the Lord comes and we all rise up to meet. What a wonderful time. I say, I know you probably already know this, but we're going to pray for you anyway. We're going to keep praying that God will work on your heart, that the Lord will bring you to salvation before it's everlasting too late. Time's running out. Please think about it. Please consider it. Next Sunday, Brother Van Collins is going to be here, being the Lord's will, and he'll be doing the preaching. And on the fourth Sunday, Brother Robbie Hawkins will be back. Then on the first Sunday, we got another Pentecostal preacher coming out of Whitesville. His name is George. What's his last name again?
Hendricks.
George Hendricks. He'll be here, being the Lord's will. And he is so excited. He's been wanting to come back to Lundale for about a year now, ain't it? Since we've had him. And he keeps saying, well, when are they going to run through all the rest of preachers so I can come back? So we got him and he's coming back. So I thank the Lord for that. We appreciate what the youth group did on their spaghetti sale.
Yeah.
If you weren't here this morning, it was a great success. They raised $1,000 to go on to the biggest thing. If you volunteered, if you contributed anything, thank you from the edge of our heart. We ain't worried about what we owe on out there, because I believe several of the men that's out here working on the building project, they all are in agreement together that within a year's time it's going to be paid off. I believe if we agree on that, I believe it'll happen. I do. I believe it'll happen. And we'll have us a dedication ceremony. If you're here for your first time, please don't let it be your last time. We love having you, and we would absolutely love having you again. And I'm glad for Brother Jeremy's dad to come with him, and I guess that's your two aunts. Okay. And we're very, very happy to have you. I'm glad we got to go to church together. We talked a little bit down at the wake the other day, or the memorial service the other day, and I'm just tickled to death to be in church with them. It's better circumstances, it's more pleasant circumstances, but I hope that you'll come back. And we got the young sister back there that I scared earlier in the service. Thank God for having you. This ain't your first time, though. You've been here before, ain't you?
She has.
This your first time?
Years ago.
Okay. I scared her to death while y'all come up behind her, just meant to shake her hand. But, I don't know. Maybe I'm just that ugly. I'm not sure. Okay. Has everybody enjoyed yourself?
Amen.
All right. Praise the Lord. Anybody else want to say anything before we go? Let's all stand if you're able to stand. And we shall reference the Lord as Brother Gary Peters, if he would, and dismiss us in a word of prayer.
Amen. I wish you.